Hey guys, what's up? I'm Rohit Khanna, host on Click Digest, and in this video, I'm gonna give you my quick review of the Intex Aqua Speed HD. Let's get started. Starting with the design of the phone, it does remind me of Sony Xperia design, to be frank. It looks very much inspired from Sony design. It uses a metal-like finish on the sides, which is not real metal. It is a high-quality glossy finish plastic. It comes with a rounded power key as well as a volume rocker just on top of it, and the buttons are fairly tactile in nature. On top of the phone, there is standard charging port and 3.5mm audio port, while the left side is totally clean. On the bottom, there is nothing, and the indent for microphone is provided in the bezel. There is a 4.7 inch HD IPS display with the quality that really impresses me. The color quality as well as viewing angles on this phone are really brilliant, and the display panel quality is just superb. The audio quality from the speakerphone is fairly decent and loud, but when you place it on a flat surface, it tends to get muffled as the speaker is placed at the rear. Talking about the cameras, there is an 8 megapixel rear and a 5 megapixel front facing camera, but the quality is just about average. The rear camera does a comparatively better job compared to the front facing cameras and can also record full high definition videos, but we were not very impressed with the quality of pictures that we saw from both of these cameras. At most, I can rate them as average. When it comes to performance, we tested on Antutu and we got a score of around 18,000, which is because it uses a chipset which is 1.3 GHz quad-core MediaTek chipset, which is found on phones like the Android One. That is not a very powerful chipset. It comes with 2GB of RAM, which means that there will be smoother multitasking, but there is some amount of lag that we noticed, and the GPU is also not very powerful. However, it did manage well at playing games. Talking about the software, it runs Android KitKat 4.4 and has a customized user interface, which looks very much like an animated sort of interface. It comes with large icons and looks kind of old style. There are a lot of pre-installed application or bloatware, as to say, and the overall UI is not very impressive. Talking about the battery, it comes with a 1700 milliamp battery, which seems slightly inadequate for the phone of this size and may not last one full day if you are a heavy user. For moderate to light user, it will still go through one full day. But if you play a lot of games, you may have to charge it in just half a day. Summing up my review, I would say this phone is a mixed bag. If you are looking for something with a brilliant display, 2GB of RAM, good smooth multitasking, and decent audio and video quality, it is a great phone. But if you are looking for something which is meant for gaming, comes with high performance, this is not the phone. It comes with moderate performance at best. It is not meant for gaming and is not meant for heavy use because the battery here is not very supportive for heavy tasks. Between 7 to 8,000 rupees, this is a good and stylish phone to use, but it is still not what we expected it to be in the price segment. This is all we have on this video. We hope you enjoyed watching it. If you did, don't forget to give us a thumbs up by pressing the like button below. And for latest video updates, make sure to hit the red subscribe button. This is your host Rohit Khurana signing off. Thanks for watching.